Assalamualaikum warahmatullahi wabarakatuh. In this conference, I want to explain about how comparative studies of several methods for building simple traceability and identifying the quality aspect of requirement in SRS documents. There was an outline, free outline. There was a comparison flowchart, ontology construction, and also a comparison method. In this research, I want to explain how comparison flowchart various method in requirement specification documents. This goal is the purpose of this study is a comparison and combined flowchart of several methods to create requirement standards in a software requirement specification SRS document for traceability analysis. This dataset description, there are functional and non-functional requirement in the software document specification SKPL. This the comparison flowchart, there was comparison and clustering process. The weighting term is the process to carry out the weighting X of existing requirement. There was TF, ETF, and also quotient similarity. And then comparison. There was a comparison several methods to find the best result for each requirement. I want to compare how the ontology compare with information retrieval, and then information retrieval plus LDA, information retrieval plus LSD. After to get the good result, we also using a clustering process to get to classify which requirement that was a better result, and then we get accuracy, precision, recall, and F1 score. And then we want to build an ontology of the software requirement specification document. The purpose of this research is to construct an ontology from SRS document and also the data set from the functional and non-functional requirement. This ontology construction flowchart, there was an original corpus, and then get to text preprocessing and go to frequent item set mining, and then how to make a feature item set, and then from item set get combination and standardization, then standardization feature item set, and then document vector. And also from the document vector, we could train a new corpus to get it in the clustering. From the clustering, we go to ontology construction. From ontology construction, we can get an ontology. Okay, and then the original corpus is form of a comma separated value to retrieve this requirement statement feature from functional and non-functional requirement. Like this one from this table. And then after that, text preprocessing. The text preprocessing is include lowercase form, punctuation removal, limited punctuation, synchronization, buffer removal, and then stemming to get the cleaning text from this result. And then feature item set. From feature item set, there was a TF-IDF to make how to count the number of occurrence of word in a document, meaning that more the word often appears, then fitting will increase linearly. Like this one, the word user is more than one value, and then we get the value between 0 and 1. But 0 means is no similarity or there was a word in that sentences. And after that, we got a combination and standardization using TF-IDF and then quotient similarity. From those combination, we get a similarity between functional and non-functional. Functional with functional or non-functional with non-functional. And then we got the result from this picture. And then we got the standardization, how the value between range from 1 to 0. 1 is indicates there was a high similarity, but 0 indicates no similarity at all. So the lowest value indicates 0. And then document factor. We get document factor using word2fact. How do word2fact it means? We want to train those document into how range the distance between those document. The closest with those word, it means the similar or is have a similarity index or similarity meaning. Like so we get the document like this one. And then after that we get clustering. That clustering it is to classify what it means. There was how to classify the words, how to classify the similarity index using the Gamins clustering algorithm that may classify group of those word. And then ontology construction, after we get the Gamins clustering, we then go to clustering hierarchy. This clustering hierarchy make it closest word with another. The closest make one hierarchy, just like this one. have a group, one color group, but it's not a similar one. There's a different color, like this one, black, green, etc. And then after that, we compare with information retrieval with using combined VSM with topic modeling. The goal description is to develop how the VSM and topic modeling of requirement statement is to specify for traceability analysis. And then data set description also is a functional and non-functional requirement in software requirement specification. But before information retrieval technique, we have prepositioning, also there was a remove punctuation, tokenization, stopper removal, punctuation deletion, and stemming to get a clean text from noise. After that, we add a part of space to know how to want to pruning the word with text and an VP or an adjective. After that, after we get to classify those constraints, we want to get a similarity index using TF-VDF, yeah, to get a result like this one. Example F functional one using user, there was an index 0.078 and then 0.64 with missing new. And then after information retrieval, we got a data set has an accuracy about 0.93 and precision of 0.76 and recall of 0.68, while data set 2 has an accuracy 0.61 and precision of 0.40 and a recall of 0.56. And then after that, we move on to combined procedure using a topic model. Same as before, the first step we do using a prepositioning like removing spaces, unedited number, then stemming, we got to let things stopper to get a cleaned word we want. After that, we want to waiting process using back of words and VSM methods. And the next step, we comparison with the LSA. LSA from we result, the LSA is good enough from using coming to get an accuracy and data accuracy. After that, we get to know to visualize term of topic modeling, how machines cluster to one another. And then after that, after LSA, we also using an LSA. From the LSA that using a singular value decomposition SVD, we got 20 topic models to correspond the number of process obtained. There was 20 LS topics model based on traceability matrix. And then we got the TF-VDF and NMF of using LDA. LDA in here, we use TF-VDF with NMF. We compare it, and then we got 10 topics from those requirement. It's more or less than LSA. I think it is not enough accurate because it is more not good enough to know this. It is mean. And then the comparison table between all methods, there was like this one. This table one represent the ER value has a high accuracy value than another methods, while ontology has accuracy, precision, recall, and F1 score value, which are considered stable at 0.7, while information retrieval plus LSA is in the range of 0.7, and information retrieval plus LDA is in value stable at 0.6. What another with the table 2, this table represents that information retrieval value has a high accuracy, same as before, yeah, than another method, while ontology has an accuracy, precision, recall, and F1 score value, which are considered stable at 0.5, and also information retrieval plus LSA is 0.5. Information retrieval with LDA is in value stable at 0.7. So the conclusion we got from this research that have been carried out, the information retrieval method gets the highest score, but accuracy, memory, and F1 score are not the same between data set and data set 2. While another method, like ontology, information retrieval plus LSA, information retrieval plus LDA, have a more stable matrix, the average mathematician score from the highest to lowest in sequences is the information retrieval plus LDA method, ontology, then information retrieval plus LSA. So thank you for your attention. I want to close this video. Assalamualaikum warahmatullahi wabarakatuh.